In this video, I'm going to teach you how to use your phone to act as a camera for your xTool S1. Best part is, this is all through their software, both on the mobile app and on the PC app. Or you can just do everything from the phone. You may have noticed that a lot of lasers these days trying to tout the fact that they have a camera built in. Those cameras are never accurate. Actually, despite any kind of calibration you do, they're off by a lot. So I've learned other techniques kind of work around, at least until xTool added this feature to their software. This is an important thing to note, because the M1 Ultra is coming soon. And it's an upgrade from the original M1, which if you recall, I reviewed in this channel not long ago. So I thought, since the M1 Ultra is coming and it's not gonna have a camera in this version, it might be important to kind of highlight how to use the features in XCS in case people want to upgrade, because it's gonna be a 4-in-1 crafting machine. It is quite literally as if a Cricut Maker 3 had a baby with a 20-watt diode laser. And yes, now it will come with a rotary blade, which it didn't before. Anyway, let's move right into showing you how to get everything set up and use the new feature. First thing we're gonna do is open up the app on your computer. Start a new project and go to the right side processing tab to the shoot background button. Click that button and a dialog will appear that has a list of steps to walk you through the process of getting a calibrated background image of your laser bed from your phone's app. If you don't have the app on your phone, go install it and connect to your xTool laser. From the phone, start a new project and click the snapshot preview button in the lower left corner. Click snapshot preview from the menu that pops up. Since you haven't calibrated yet, you'll be prompted to do so. Here's the part that was a little weird. The computer app doesn't have the link to download the calibration stickers. They're not actually stickers, just markers that you place down. But the phone app does. You can print them from your phone or your computer. I prefer from the computer. I'll leave a link in the description below for the PDF file of the stickers as well as the help article. It's a pretty thorough article and great additive content to what I'm covering here. Print the calibration sticker sheet out and cut out one of the sets into 4 individual pieces. You'll place these on the laser bed in the 4 corners. The 4th sticker is the loner with the single black dot in the center. The order in which they go in is top left to top right, then bottom left to bottom right. The stickers don't have to be placed as far out as the laser can travel. However, if you want to use the whole bed, it's best to slide the laser head over and make sure you place them where the crosshairs can line up with them. I used a little bit of glue stick on the back of the paper to help it stay down on the laser bed while calibrating. The stickers need to stay there while you're actually using the laser, as it's the stickers that the app will use to recognize the laser bed and then provide the accurate image for the application. For fun, I'm just gonna toss these cardstock squares into the laser. Just kidding. I'll leave them in their random spots, but secure them with some washi tape so the fan doesn't blow them around. Use the phone app to capture a picture of the laser bed with all 4 stickers and your raw materials in it. Click the Send to Computer button to activate the QR scanner. In the computer app, click on the Obtain Background button of the Shoot Background dialog to reveal the QR code for the phone app. Hold up your phone to your computer's monitor and allow it to scan the QR code. The app will now transfer the background image and calibration information to your computer. XCS is now ready for you to place your design. I just threw some test text here in the project and positioned it over each piece. When you're ready to go, double check your settings, frame it out, and start processing. Look at how accurate this is engraving after calibrating and capturing the laser bed. Like, this is absolutely silly. Look at this. Oh my gosh. There you have it. Super simple. The only downside is you have to do this whole process every time you want to use it, meaning you have to take the stickers and put them down and calibrate where the laser points are going to be and then take a photo of the whole bed to transfer into the app. Anywho, I hope this helps you. Feel free to like the video, subscribe to the channel, or I'll eat your soul. Bye!